I am focusing the correlation, particularly in the correlation, I'm talking about the Pearson product movement correlation. So we may use the terms Pearson, otherwise Pearson product movement correlation, PPMC. That's a short form we are using, Pearson product movement correlation, Pearson product movement correlation, because this test is made by the Pearson. That's why the test itself is called Pearson product movement correlation. And even you know the difference, a lot of correlations are available, like Pearson property movement correlation, rank correlations, biserial correlation, tetrachoric correlations, pi coefficient of correlations, partial correlation, multiple correlation. But for your purpose, I think you need only the Pearson product movement correlation. That only I'm focusing. Even the Pearson product movement correlation may come to the parametric statistics. I already mentioned that the parametric statistics, the main conditions, it will be a normality. Then second one is the last sample. The third one is to be the data set should be a continuous. Okay, the same thing. See here, there is a variable X and Y. For doing the Pearson product movement correlation, we need a two variables. So how many variables we need? We need a two variable. I'm keeping as X and Y. In this case, it may be alternative. So X, if you're taking X as independent variable, Y is a dependent variable, because we are having only the two variable only, X and Y. Even if you do the vice versa, also the same results may come. If you're changing the X into Y or Y2 into X, the scores won't be changed in the case of the correlation. But in the case of regression, the interchanging is not be possible, because if you want to keep it Y, always you can keep it Y. You could not be interchanging the portion of X to Y or Y to X in the case of regression. But in the case of correlation, not at all issue. You can keep it X to Y or Y to X. That's not at all issue. Only the thing, if you are taking the two variable X and Y, the both the variables should be continuous. So this is the main conditions to adopting the Pearson product movement correlations. So continuous means what? It may be interval or ratio. The data set should may be interval or ratio. So this is a basic conditions to adopting the Pearson product movement correlation. Here I'm focusing only the Pearson product movement correlations. In this case, see here that X is a variable, Y is a variable. They given only the 8 scores, and the scores are continuous nature. The scores are continuous nature. Therefore, I'm going to do a correlations. Now, see here, I'm going to highlight the path now. Click the data, then data analysis. This path we already familiar, data and data analysis. There, I'm going with the correlation. So here, correlations. Once you click the correlation, click OK. Once you click OK, it asks the input range. In our case, X and Y both is input range. X variable and Y is the variable, both is the input range. Therefore, I am selecting the both ranges of A1 to B9. I am selecting all is the input range and label in the first row, because I am selecting X and Y, the labeling also. Then I want to select the output range. I am keeping the cursor, I am selecting the output range here. So these are the two things important. You have to select the input range of the data sets from the data sets, then select the output range. Even if you want to generate the output from the new worksheet, you can go with the new worksheet, or new workbook, you can go with new workbook. Normally, if you are getting the output, the same page is easy to check with the data, sort of the answer. That is why I'm always using the output range. So the output range, in the sense, the same sheets you are getting the results. That is why I'm keeping the output range, and you can select any column here. Okay, now after this, click OK. Now the results is ready. See this case, what is my correlation value? The red mark value is a correlation value. So what is the correlation value? Normally, it's like a matrix. It's like a correlation matrix. This is called as a correlation matrix. So it may compare like this only, X to X, because the X and X is always same. Therefore, the if you are checking the that corner, like if you are checking the cross, you may get always the one only, because the X to X, then Y to Y always one only. But we are checking the X to Y relationship only, X and Y relationship, it is called 0.630. So according to the statistical norms, 0.6 is more than 0.05. So what it means, the sense, so it's above the average, it's above the moderate level of correlation, what is that relationship happened between the two scores of x and y. So it's somewhat good correlation only, because even the correlation value is a positive one. Therefore, if the score is positive, we may use the term as a positive correlation. If the score comes negative, we may use the term as a negative correlation. In this case, there is a positive correlation between the x and y, and the positive correlation is a moderate level, because more than 0.60. Okay, so nearly 0.60. That is why we may treat it as a positive correlation. And I move to the next example of correlation. But in this case, there is a three data sets are three variables are there, x, y, z. So therefore, I am going to use the Pearson product moment correlation only. But here it's comparing with the two groups only. It not be compared with all the three groups together. Okay, so it may compare with the two groups only, x to y, x to z, and y to z. Like that only the comparison may happen. The condition to apply the Pearson product moment correlation, I already mentioned that it should be a continuous. All the three variables should be continuous. See here, there is a variable named investment, then income, then consumption. So we can check whether any that variable having the positive relationship or negative relationship. So I'm going to do a Pearson product moment correlation only. Once again, highlighting the path, I'm going to the data analysis, select the correlations, click OK. After selecting the click OK, we have to select the input range. So I'm selecting all the three scores as an input range up to the end. So there's a 92 data. Then I have to fix the output range. So I feel to keep the output in the G17. Then click OK. Then parallel you can click the labels in first row also. Then click OK. Now we are getting the output, say here. Yeah, so now this is called correlation matrix. So the 0.98 represent what? 0.98, it is represent the relationship between the income and investment. Income versus investment relationship is 0.98. It means it's near to the one. We are already familiar with the correlation band is plus or minus only. If the score is very near to the one, somewhat perfect correlation may happen. So in this case, somewhat good correlations, good positive correlations. We may use the term perfect, because if it exactly comes one, we may use the term is perfect. It is somewhat very nearer. The same way, the consumption with the consumption, I'm doing the other color. Yeah, consumptions with investment is 0.98. This also a good correlation. In the case of consumption with the income, 0.999. So it's also very highly positive correlated. The two variables are highly correlated to each other. So like that, we can come for the conclusions about the correlations. So very simple click, we may get the answers. I hope now you understand how we can do a correlation with two variable, if you have three variable or four variable. The rules are same only.